Yeah, so now there's actually, they changed the tactics.
There's one of the big sticking points people didn't want to vote for Clinton. Yeah, their military experience. But he was like the first president ever to send it. He was the world. And so that was like this huge thing. And now it's...
She wants to ensure that every family has that path to the American dream. And she wants every child to be able to get a quality education and wants to create jobs and opportunities for everybody. But let me tell you, those aren't the only reasons why I'm supporting Hillary Clinton. Besides being extraordinarily qualified to run for this office, she is the only candidate in this race who will actually get things done. Let me tell you, it doesn't help just to be a voice if you can't get things accomplished. You need to work with others to advance an agenda. Your ideas need to be turned into action. Sometimes it takes a realist who can turn our ideals into real laws. As her husband, President Bill Clinton recently said of her, Hillary is a doer. As First Lady, she fought for tax credits that encourage families to adopt special needs children. As Senator Clinton, she went to President George W. Bush to ensure New York City would be rebuilt after it was attacked on 9/11. And she continued to work across the aisle with Republicans to get things done on healthcare, and even climate change. Look, we know that as president, she will get things done. Between her work ethic, her experience, and her understanding of how Washington works, she will be a force. Let me repeat this. She will be a force to be reckoned with.
Well, hello, Salinas! sincerely hope is your next Congressman, Jimmy Panetta. You know, Jimmy brings a lifetime of experience, a former prosecutor, a veteran with naval intelligence experience, someone whose roots are deep in this part of California. He's here today with his wife, Carrie, and his daughters, Siri and Gia, and his mother, Sylvia Panetta, who runs the Panetta Institute. Now, I'm not just here giving a pro forma endorsement of Jimmy Panetta. I know this family, you know this family, and you know the service that this family has rendered. Service that is exceptional, with integrity, that produces results for the people here in California and across America. I had the great privilege of working with Leon Panetta when he was in my husband's administration. And then I had the great privilege when I was Secretary of State, working first with Leon Panetta when he was the director of the CIA, and he will be, because the apple doesn't fall far from the tree. I also want to thank the Hartnell Jazz Band. They played for us. And everybody who was part of that pre-program. I am so excited to be here. For the time we have here together, what's at stake in this election? The stakes could not be higher for each and every one of us. No matter what walk of life, no matter your background, no matter your interests and concerns, we have a really big choice before us as a nation. Now, I happen to think we are stronger together. We are stronger when we are united, not divided. The economy does better when we have a Democrat in the White House. And you know, we don't have to go back to ancient history. Go back to when my husband was president in the 1990s. With the help of Leon Panetta, who was in charge of the budget, they set us on a course that led to 23 million new jobs. Incomes rose for everybody, not just people at the top. Median family income was up by double digits. More people lifted out of poverty. And we ended up with a balanced budget and a surplus. We were on the right track, my friends. What happened is that we got a Republican president and a issue. Cut taxes on the wealthy. They call it trickle down. The problem is, it only works for the wealthy. It doesn't work for everybody else. So the Republicans cut taxes, then they took their eye off the financial markets and the mortgage markets. And you know what happened here in California. You saw it. The worst financial crisis since the Great Depression. And what we've got to do now is continue with confidence and optimism to create new jobs. And I don't think President Obama gets the credit he deserves for digging us out of the ditch. In Salinas, to hear this, because when Donald Trump talks about deporting, forcibly deporting 11 million immigrants, he's not only talking about ripping families apart, is he? He is talking about deporting more than one half of the 2.4 million farm workers who help feed our country. To do. Comprehensive immigration reform is one way that we will invest in building a stronger future together. And here's another. In my first 100 days, I will send a plan to Congress to make the biggest, most forward-looking investment in American infrastructure in 50 years. $25 billion, that could be used to build 16 Golden Gate Bridges. It could be used to build 1,500 new elementary schools. It could be used to send more than 300,000 veterans to college. Trump wants to spend on his wall. And I think it would be a much better investment for our country. But I've concluded that Donald Trump doesn't seem to actually care about making America great so much as he cares about looking great himself. Recession. 9 million Americans lost their jobs. 5 million homes were lost. You multiply that by 3, 4, 5, 6 people living in those homes. Tens of millions of Americans were directly affected, and I bet every one of us knows somebody, if not ourselves, somebody who was affected. So when we think about what happened to our country, it's shocking to learn that Donald Trump actually rooted for, spoke positively about the housing crash. He actually said that it would be a good way to make money. We found a video clip of him saying that, and we put it out on the internet. And you know what he said in response? Well, he bragged. He said, and I'm quoting now, "That's the kind of thinking our country needs." He said, profiting off working people losing their homes would be, and I quote, "a good result." Now, a good result in Donald Trump's world is he gets his and you get hurt. Instead of dividing Americans, we're going to build infrastructure that will connect Americans to opportunity and to the jobs of the future. We're going to connect every household to the internet by 2020 and put Wi-Fi in more schools, hospitals, and transit systems so you can go anywhere online at any time. We're going to build a cleaner, more resilient power grid with enough renewable energy to get half our electricity from clean sources by 2030 and to fight climate change. We're going to have safe, high-tech public schools everywhere. We're going to be really building America. Don't you think that's what we should be doing? Was written by a billionaire for billionaires. I think the billionaires in America have had quite a good ride. I'm now interested in everybody else in America having the same opportunity to go as far as your heart will take you. Now, in addition to growing the economy and creating jobs that we can do right here at home, I think we need to make the economy fairer. I do think we need to raise the minimum wage, and I know we've got some farm workers here and farm worker union representatives. I think we've got to look at overtime and other important ways to lift people out of poverty. And I also think it is way past time to guarantee that women get equal pay for the work. If you have a mother, a wife, a daughter, a sister, and we all have at least one of those, anyway, mother, if you have any woman you know in your family who is working, if she's not being paid equally, then the whole family is suffering.
That's right.
The family's income is down. So this is a family issue. This is an economic issue. And it is time that we do everything we can to require businesses to pay women what they deserve so that they giving paid family leave so families can balance their work and other responsibilities. Donald Trump says, oh, there she goes, playing the woman's card. Well, if talking about being treated fairly and equally is playing the woman's card, then deal me in. Through education. It is still the principal pathway to opportunity. And I think we've got to start with early childhood education. I want every child to be prepared to succeed in school. And I want to work with our teachers and our educators to make sure in elementary and secondary education, we help every child succeed as far as that child can. And we are going to do more to provide support for community colleges so that they can be free, so that students can afford to get the degrees and the credentials that they need to have a good job. And we're going to make four-year public colleges and universities free in the sense that you will not have to borrow money. You will not have to borrow money to pay tuition. Institutions like Hartnell that are serving a lot of first-generation students, and I want to help you pay down your debt and get out from under it so you're not crippled by your student debt any longer. And we're going to keep working to make health care of high quality and affordable. That's why I support the Affordable Care Act that President something called Hillary Care. Because we worked really hard to get quality, affordable health care back when my husband was president. We weren't successful, but I turned around, worked with Democrats and Republicans to pass the Children's Health Insurance Program, which provides health care to 8 million children and young people in our country. So we're going to get the cost down, premiums, co-pays, deductibles, prescription drug costs. And we're going to do two more things. We're going to do more to help people with mental health problems and addiction. Get well, get treatment, get into recovery. So you see, I believe that when you're making your mind up about who to vote for president, the first thing is, can this person produce results that will improve the lives of yourselves, your families, and the people in our country across this great land of ours? If you cannot do that, then you're just making empty promises. If you can't, as Jimmy Panetta said, get it done, then you're just making speeches. I have a track record of producing results, and if you give me the chance to serve, safe, protect the American people, lead with strength and steadiness around the world. That's a big issue, because when you go to vote in this June 7th primary, you're voting for commander-in-chief as well as president. And this is where what Donald Trump says is most disturbing, if you can believe it. It's hard to pick, I know. But think about it. Just in the last 2 weeks, he has attacked our most important ally, Britain. He has praised the dangerous dictator in North Korea. He has suggested he doesn't mind if more countries have nuclear weapons, for heaven's sakes. He is advocating pulling out of NATO, our strongest military alliance. He's actually said, let's return to torture. He wants to ban all Muslims, except where he makes exceptions. That is a terrible message to send the world. You know, when you're running for president, the rest of the world's actually listening. And when you are president, they pay really close attention to what the American president says and does. I find what he says about foreign policy and national security not just offensive, but dangerous. And it really matters who is in the situation room making these decisions. Easy decisions don't end up before the president, only the hard ones do. And I'll tell you a story because it involves Leon Panetta and I think tells you something about what kind of public official Jimmy would be. You know, I was, as Jimmy said, a senator from New York when we were attacked on 9/11. I was at ground zero within 24 hours because people I knew had been murdered by Al-Qaeda. 3,000 people there and at the Pentagon and plane in Pennsylvania, murdered without remorse in pursuit of a horrible, evil agenda. So I had a personal commitment in doing everything I could to bring bin Laden to justice. And one day, Leon Panetta, who was then the director of the CIA, came to see me over at the State Department. He said, we want you to be part of a small group that's going to advise the president as to whether or not we have enough good intelligence to go after bin Laden. And we started just painstakingly going through that intelligence, asking every question we could imagine. And then finally it became time to advise the president. And that small group of us sitting in the Situation Room, all experienced, expert people, we didn't all agree. Some said, you know, I don't think the intelligence is good enough. We shouldn't take the risk. Others said, well, I think it's good enough for a missile strike, but not good enough to send in special forces. And when they got to me, I said, no, I think we need to send in special forces because we need to find out for sure if the person we think is bin Laden is there. That's what Director Panetta had advised too. So we finished giving our advice, but you know what happened then? The president said he had to go think about it. He had to go deliberate. Because at the end of the day, you can listen to all the advice in the world, but the decision has to be made by the person we choose to be president and commander-in-chief. The president made that decision, and we did bring bin Laden to justice. Country, not divide us against one another. And I have to tell you the kind of divisive, hateful rhetoric that Donald Trump uses is bad for America. You know, calling immigrants terrible names, making fun of a person with a disability, impugning John McCain's wartime heroism. It is unbelievable the kinds of things he has said. And some people, I think, say, well, he can't possibly mean all that, but here's what I want you to understand. If you don't say what you mean when you're running for president, what are you out there doing? What he is saying. Because when I tell you what I want to do for new jobs and raising incomes, I expect you to hold me accountable. I've seen how hard the presidency is. I know how difficult the decisions are. And we have to take it seriously from beginning all the way through the years of service. So pay attention to what Donald Trump says, because he's telling you what he wants to do. He does want to have a deportation force to round up 11 million people to deport them, which will mean knocking on doors, maybe in your home where somebody works, rounding up the farm workers in the fields, taking people off of construction jobs, separating parents from their children. Is that the kind of country we are? I don't think so. President, but I can't do any of this without your help. I need your help in the June 7th primary. So please, if you have a ballot at home, mail it in. Get that out of the way. Just check my name, check Jimmy Panetta's name, you're done. We need a big turnout in California because I want to send a message that California, which is a diverse, big, dynamic state, is looking